A very good morning, dear children. I hope you all are fit and fine at your homes. Welcome back to the English class. So children, in the previous class, we have learned about the golden touch. Yes? The story about King Midas. Yes, children? So children, chapter number 1, the golden touch. So children, in today's class, we are going to discuss a evaluation part of this chapter. Okay, now turn the page. Okay, open your English textbook, page number 7. Now children, read, tick the right options to complete these sentences. So children, here what we have to do, we have to tick the right options to complete these sentences. Okay. The sentence number 1, King Midas was a very rich man because he had, tell me which option is right, option A, many friends, option B, good health, option C, an intelligent mind, or option D, lots of gold. Yes, we know that King Midas was very, very rich man because he had lots of gold. Yes, children, so option number D is right. But now read the second sentence. More than gold, King Midas loved his, yes, you are right, daughter. Then read the third one. Every day King Midas would, option A, go for a walk, look at his gold, read to his daughter, meet the people of his kingdom. So children, tell me which one is right, which option is right. Yes, look at his gold, because every day King Midas would look at his gold. Now King Midas was not a very happy man because he wanted more gold. So option B is right. The gold was kept so in a safe place, or in a dark room in the king's palace, or in a shed, or in king's cupboard. Yes, tell me where it was kept. It was kept in a dark room in the king's palace. So option B is right. Yes, children, now listen to me carefully, okay? I will send the PDF of this question answers, okay? I will send you the answers of each question. So don't worry about that. First, listen to me carefully, okay? Here, we only discuss the question answers, okay? So children, come to the B section, answer this question, okay? I will ask you a question and you have to try to give answer to this question. Okay, the first question is, who appeared in the dark room one day? So now tell me, who appeared in the dark room one day? The answer is, yes, a stranger appeared in the dark room one day. Yes, a stranger appeared in the dark room one day. Now the second question, what did he ask King Midas? Now tell me the answer, children. The king said he was unhappy. Yes, he asked King Midas how much gold he needed to be happy. So children, the question number 2, what did he ask King Midas? Yes, he asked King Midas how much gold he need to be happy. So children, here he refers to the stranger. Here he refers to that stranger who appeared in the dark room. Okay, so here he refers to that stranger. So what did the stranger ask to King Midas? The answer is, the stranger asked to King Midas how much gold he needed to be happy. Okay, so answer for this question. Now read the third question. Why did the king say he was unhappy? Tell me, children. Because the king said he was unhappy as he wanted more gold. Yes? So the answer of this question is that the king said he was unhappy as he wanted more gold. Okay? Don't worry about that. I will send you answers for this question. I will send you a PDF. Okay? Just here you listen to me. That's it. Okay? Discuss the question answers. Here we are here to discuss the question answers. So children, the third question is, why did the king say he was unhappy? Because the king said he was unhappy because as he wanted more gold. Yes? Now Now the fourth question, what was the king's wish? The king's wish was that everything he touched be turned into gold. Yes? Now the question number 5. What did the stranger grant the king? The stranger granted the king the golden touch. Yes? The stranger granted the king the golden touch. Okay? Now come to the C section, think and answer. The first question is, why was King Midas unhappy at the start of the story? Now think and tell me, children. Try to answer this question. Yes? Why was King Midas unhappy at the start of the story? We know that King Midas had lot of gold and he was very, very rich. Then why he was very upset and unhappy at the start of the story? The answer of this question is that the king Midas was unhappy at the start of the story because he wanted more gold. Yes? So now the second question. Was there a change in King Midas by the end of the story? Give reason for your answer. Children, think and answer me. Was there a change in King Midas by the end of the story? Yes? There is lots of change. So yes, there was a change in King Midas by the end of the story. Yes, children, he learned his lesson and become a wise and noble king. Yes, children, at the end of the story, he learned his lesson and he become a wise and noble king. And he realized that gold was not the most valuable thing in the world. Yes, children? Okay. Now let's move to the next page, okay? Open your English textbook. Okay, now turn the page. Page number 8, okay? So here, children, see, using grammar. Yes, using grammar. You have already learned that the name of a person or thing is called a noun. For example, you write with a pencil and that is its name. Yes? You comb your hair with a comb or hairbrush and that is its name. Such names are called common nouns. They are general or common names. Some other examples are boy, girl, cat and spider. Yes, these are common names, general or common names. So children, in bridge course, we have learned about noun, pronoun, and types of nouns. Yes, common noun, proper noun. We have learned about this in our bridge course. Yes, so once again, I am repeating this. So children, here see. Yes, we already know about the whole concept about noun, pronoun, and about the types of nouns. So yes, so children, here, see, names of a person or thing is called a noun. Yes, so for example, you write up with a pencil and that is its name. So you comb your hair with a comb or hairbrush and that is its name. Such names are called common nouns, like pencil, hairbrush, like boy, girl. Yes, they all are common nouns. We are not saying a particular name, like you are Ramesh, you are Anita, you are Rani, you are Raja. We are not saying the names. We are not saying a particular name. We are just saying boy, girl. Yes, so these names are common names. Yes, hairbrush, pencil. We don't know the name of that particular thing. Yes, so these are called common names we have learned in our bridge course. Yes, so children, and now what we have to do, we have to underline the common nouns in these sentences. Okay, the first sentence is, the king lived in a big palace. Yes, what we have to do, we have to underline the common nouns here. King is a common noun because we have not mentioned the specific name of that king. Yes, we just said king. So king is a common noun. Yes, king lived in a big palace. Palace is also a common noun because we are not mentioning here the particular name for this mansion. Yes, so king and palace, like that. His garden was full of blooming flowers. Yes, which flower? We don't know. So which garden? We don't know. Then garden and flowers are common nouns. So now the third one. A stranger appeared in his room suddenly. Room, which room? We don't know. Which stranger? We don't know the particular name of that stranger. Yes, so stranger and room are common nouns. Now, the curtains and the bedsheets and his clothes all turn into gold. Curtains, bedsheet and clothes are common now, okay? He had to sprinkle water to get everything back to its original form. So, foam and water are a common nouns. Okay, children, is that clear? Now, see, when we say Anita, like that, I also told you, no? If we use a particular name of a person, that means it's a proper noun. Yes, we have learned this in our bridge course, children. Yes, so see here, when we say Anita, means see here, Anita used the blue pencil. Here, Anita is a proper noun because we are using a particular name of a person. We are not saying girl. Yes. A girl used the blue pencil. We are saying Anita used the blue pencil. So Anita is a proper noun. Anita used a comb to untangle your hair. Then we are using a special or specific name, Anita. So children, this is called a proper noun. Okay. So a proper noun can be the name of a person, a country such as India, your school, or your pet. A proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Yes, children, we have already known about this, that a proper noun always begin with a capital letter. CSS, KK English Medium School is a specific name. Yes, and India, we lives in India. India is a specific name of a place. Yes, of a country. India is a country. Yes, so these are specific name, Anita, India. Yes, these are proper noun. Yes. Now, section B, create your own proper nouns in these sentences. Okay, the place that what we have to do, we have to create our own proper nouns. Yes, what we have to do, we have to create our own proper noun. Like, we know that the palace that King Midas lived in was called like Shinyaveli. Okay. So now here, see, his daughter name was, let's write here, Maria. Okay, his daughter name was Maria. Now turn the page. Okay, children, so see here, he lived in the city called Athens. Yes, he lived in the city of Athens. Athens is also a name of a city. So Athens is a proper noun. So the river from which water was brought was called London. The stranger's name was Cyrus. So children, these are proper nouns, yes, which we have create our own. Now, section C, complete these sentences with the right words from the box. So children, what you have to do, here they have given some collective nouns. Collective nouns, we have already learned this, yes. Collective noun is a word that describes a collection or a group of people, animals or things. For example, every day a bunch of roses was placed at the king's table. Bunch of roses means group of roses. Yes, a swarm of bees surrounded the sweet smelling flower. Yes. Now come to the C section. Complete these sentences with the right words from the book. Now what we have to do, children, we have to complete these sentences with the right words from this above box. Okay, children, from this above box. So first one is, the dash of soldiers marched past the palace. So which option is right here? Yes, army. The army of soldiers marched past the palace. Now, a pile of unwashed bed sheets lay in the dark room. A pile of unwashed bed sheets lay in the dark room. Now the third one, every day a flock. Yes, every day a flock of birds visited the royal garden. Yes, the first one is army, then second pile, then third one is flock. The king's daughter had a large circle of friends. Large circle of friends. The river was surrounded by clump of trees. A herd of cattle grazed in the field. Children, so children, now I hope you are getting my point. Now come to the D section. What we have to do, we have to unscramble the words to get the collective nouns. Okay, children, what we have to do? We have to unscramble the words. Okay, so see here. So here, see, unscramble the words. Okay, the first word is O-R-H-A-D. Is there any meaning in that? No. Then what we have to do? We have to unscramble the words to get the collective nouns. Yes? Hard. H-O-A-R-D. Now, second one. T-E-T-T-E-R-T-E. L-I. So, is there no meaning? So, what we have to do? We have to unscramble the letters. Litter. Yes? The third one is pack. And the fourth one is crowd. Yes? A-C-P-K. Is there no meaning in this word? So, what we have to do? We have to unscramble these words. The third one is pack. And the last one is crowd. Okay? Now, turn the page. Okay, here, see. Using words. Okay, children, a word that means the same as another is called a synonymous. So, children, synonymous means we have already learned about this in our bridge course. So, children, synonymous means what? Synonymous means a word that means the same as another is called a synonymous. Like, for example, sad, miserable and unhappy. Other, that means the same as another. Yes? So, here what we have to do? We have to underline the right synonymous from the brackets, okay? From the brackets for the highlighted words given in the sentences. King Midas was delighted. Delighted synonymous are happy. Yes, delighted means what, children? Delighted means happy, okay? So, King Midas was delighted, happy, when his daughter came back to life. Now, the second one is, King Midas was very rich. Rich means wealthy. So, King Midas finally became a wise. Wise means what, children? Sensible. Yes, as we know that synonymous means the same as another. Yes, it's called synonymous. So, wise means sensible. King Midas also learned that gold is not the most precious thing in the world. Precious means what? Worthless or valuable? Yes, you are right. Valuable. So, underline the word valuable. Now, satisfied. So, children, now what is mean by satisfied? Here, satisfied means pleased. Yes? Pleased. Satisfied at having so much gold, King Midas for breakfast. So, children, the stranger granted him the golden touch and disappeared. So, children, what is mean by disappeared? Disappeared means vanished. Okay? So, what we have to do? We have to underline the synonymous. Yes? As we know, synonymous means what? Synonymous means the same as another. Yes? It's called a synonymous. Okay? What you have to do? You have to underline these words. Happy, wealthy, sensible. Yes? So, precious means valuable. Satisfied means pleased. So, now, B section. Match the words in column A with their opposite in columns B. Bright, dull. Difficult, easy. Yes? Then quite, noisy. White, narrow. Tidy, untidy. Difficult, easy. Bright, dull. Okay, children? So, now turn the page. Page number 12. So, children, this is your homework, okay? What you have to do? This is a story of a King Midas, but the sentences are not in the right order. So, what you have to do? You have to rearrange these sentences and write the correct number, okay? Write the correct numbers beside the sentences. So, children, this is your homework. You have to do it and send it to my personal number, okay, children? I hope you understood this. Till then, stay home. We will continue in next class. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.